Namaste, this is Mekhala here from poojas.in. Today I received an email from a lady called Veena from Madhya Pradesh, India. She was saying that, you know, she has a sister by name Sheetal. So whatever Sheetal does, Sheetal is her younger sister, and she says that whatever she does, she's always attracting good luck. Sometimes she does nothing and still things work for her, whereas when she does anything, nothing happens. And she says Veena is more hardworking than Sheetal. So she's like, how do I capture that instant good luck? So I think this whole generation is very instant. And in fact, my previous video was about instant prosperity. And incidentally, I've got this mail on instant good luck. Well, first thing that you need to know is, first you start avoiding bad luck, automatically good luck will come to you. Maybe Sheetal is lucky enough mainly because of her past life karmas. She must have performed very good deeds in the past. She must have performed a lot of charity in the past. She must have respected the elders very much in the past lives, I'm saying. And all that will be like a fixed deposit account in her karmic account. And in this janma or in this life, she starts enjoying the benefit of the savings that she has made. So what you need to do is get a Sundara khanda parayana done in your name and star. We do it at poojas.in, we do it on Saturdays, we do it on Tuesdays. So we do it in two ways, one is Tulsi Ramayan and another one is Valmiki Ramayan. So if you can get that done in your name and star, one thing that will really help is all the shatrubada, negativity, karma, karmic residues would get cleansed. Another thing that we can do is a Hanuman Chalisa Parayana. See, I think almost all North Indians and people from Central India and everywhere, actually, I can say, chanting Hanuman Chalisa is like a household thing. But you should not it's just not chanting it once, like chanting it a certain number of times. Like even in the Palashruti, it's mentioned that we have to chant it a certain number of times to get certain desired result. So if we start chanting Hanuman Chalisa on your behalf, we have our priests who do it regularly. Like say 11 times, 21 times, 108 times, you know, this kind of parayana if we do regularly, lot of negativity gets released from you and you start attracting good luck. See, good luck is not always necessarily only Lakshmi or Ganesha. Ganesha, Lakshmi are very important, I know that. But one fact that you don't know, or you may not know, 99% people don't know is that Hanuman was the most richest person. He had all the Navanidhis. In fact, it comes in Hanuman Chalisa. Ashta Siddhi Navanidhi Ke Data. So why? Because he has all the treasures. In fact, he is more wealthy than Kubera. So, but because of his sense of wisdom and Vairagya, he did not get attached to it. But it doesn't mean he didn't have it. He had it all. See, that is the beauty of our, Sanatana Dharma, if you see. It doesn't say you renounce everything means just be without it. It says that you be with it, but not be attached to it. But coming back to your question, you want to attract good luck. If you want to attract good luck, if you want to capture good luck, if you want good luck to be your first name, your middle name and your last name. Veena, good luck. Good luck, Veena. And good luck, like that, you know. If you want to be like that, like your younger sister Sheetal, so I would suggest that you do this. Maybe you did not do so many good things in your past, so what? You also stand a chance. Just as much as she is enjoying, you also need to enjoy. So one thing you can do is Sundara khanda parayana for a certain number of weeks, and Hanuman Chalisa parayana every day for a certain number of days. Both will get you good luck and prosperity, okay? And you will also get the courage to do whatever you want to achieve. So, for example, if you're trying your luck very hard to achieve some, goal, like you make 10 attempts to achieve once, now that will get reduced. So, as in when you're doing parayana, you'll feel the result. You'll start feeling that, oh, correct, I'm able to achieve it in 3 times. Then, as we continue further, you'll start realizing that in your very first attempt, you're able to achieve. So, in your very first attempt, if you're able to achieve, that means you're closer to good luck. And when you don't make an attempt and things come and fall in your lap, that means you are already good luck. So you just see how your life is before the parayanam, and after we do the chants, how your life is going to be, you can compare it yourself. So I would recommend this for you to become Miss Good Luck, Queena. Okay, I wish you all the best. I hope to talk to you soon on this. Let's just do the Hanuman Chalisa and the Sundara Khanda Parayana for you, and let's make you Miss Good Luck soon. Thank you. Namaste.